Hi, and welcome to this week's episode of The Shtick, where we're enjoying a beautiful day. We had to wait for the gardener to mow the lawn, but now we're ready to go. And in the circumstances that we're in at the moment, where we have a visitor from Israel, who I was so thrilled to see on Saturday, and I invited her to come on the show, and her name is Olamit Wolf.
Hi, Henry.
Hi, Olamit. It's a difficult name.
It's a very heavy name. It's a big name to get out there, and because it's got three syllables.
Do you have a nickname?
It was Mitty, and now it's Ola.
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 Ola's very Ola, Russian. Ola. We've got so many
Spanish,
Russians in
Russian,
it. Russian, yeah. Of course, Ola.
Yeah.
I love it. And you're here visiting family.
I'm here visiting my family, who I believe you hosted my father, so I've got some big shoes to fill here on your show.
And your brother Menachem
and
as well.
And my brother Menachem, obviously.
Yeah, the Wolf, famous Spirit Grow family.
Yeah, very blessed to be
you
part
are.
Of that family.
And you're the oldest of seven.
And I'm the oldest who, I think, paved the way for some of them.
Yeah, I know. Well, it's a big responsibility, and it's awesome being the daughter of a guru.
Yeah.
And also your mother, Leah, is a goddess.
A goddess herself.
She is.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And I think we come from a lineage of goddesses and very special people.
Yeah,
you
I remember
know.
Your as grandmother, big, yes, your yes. your mother's mother from Sydney, because they came from Sydney.
That's right.
The big joining of the Melbourne and Sydney
That's
clans.
Right. The intermarriage.
And your uncle is the very famous centenarian.
Yes. The one living in Israel.
No, the one who wrote the book about the Holocaust.
Oh, my great-uncle.
Your great-uncle.
Okay. Yes, Adi Jaku, incredible man with an incredible story.
Yeah, it was one of the best interviews I've ever done, even though
really?
We were on Zoom.
Yes.
It was just fantastic to meet somebody of that mental strength.
Correct, mental strength. Mm. And who shared a different approach, and he had a different reaction to the Holocaust, different to my grandmother, and equally important, his focus was on happiness and being a survivor, and from being a victim to a survivor. And I would say the other side of the family, my Kessel side of the family, was very much into being very aware of who our enemies are, not mincing our words when it comes to calling them out, and pledging that it will never happen again, that being the Holocaust.
Yeah, and with a sense of revenge, you know, needing to
a very strong sense of revenge.
And justice.
And the justice was ultimately her moving to Israel and us carrying on and fulfilling her dream. By being in Israel, that's the ultimate justice.
And your living in Israel is also your dream.
And yes, I'm living my dream.
In Tel Aviv?
In Tel Aviv at the moment.
Ya Habibi Tel Aviv.
Ya Habibi Tel Aviv.
We love Tel Aviv.
We do. I've learned so much from Tel Avivniks. And the truth is, Henry, I was cynical about Tel Aviv people. I thought they were shallow. Mm. I thought they were evacuees. And they're not. I think they're very spiritual beings with complete faith and belief that tomorrow will be a better day. And that I learned by being in Tel Aviv during COVID time.
During COVID time
during
would have
COVID
been
time.
So difficult. And you're the mother of three beautiful children.
Thank you.
And
yes.
as well as being a grandmother, your
and
daughter
I'm a granny.
Has had a little girl.
A little grandson.
A grandson, that's right.
So I'm very blessed.
And that's fantastic. So we have to talk to you about what you do. You're professionally a Chinese medicine
Correct.
Doctor.
I've been doing that for about 19 years.
Right.
So my background is science and the health sciences predominantly. Mm. But that was something I was very passionate about. And as you know my background, it's obvious that one of us are going to follow in my father's footsteps. And my mother too was very, very holistic. So.
Yeah.
we essentially came from a family of hippies.
Yeah, so spirit grow is that.
Right, it just evolved into something a little bit more sophisticated, but that's where we come from.
It's a breakaway from Hasidus.
It's a form of Hasidus.
Yeah, it's a form of.
It's a form of.
Because Menachem and Label keep everything very, very kosher.
Correct.
And your mother is a phenomenal. I've eaten at your parents' place several times and been to kiddushes that your mother has arranged.
Yes.
And you followed in her footsteps as a foodie.
I think I did. Yeah. I think we all did to some extent. Mm. I think it's our language of love.
Yeah, it really is.
And it is a language of love, isn't it? I think it unites people at the end of the day.
Yes, it does.
And what a great thing to think about at night when you can't sleep, or what an amazing discussion when you have lulls in conversations. It's just, food is everything.
It is. It keeps us alive.
Yes.
And you've done an amazing job, and that's one of the main reason I invited you.
I was wondering why I've been invited. What can I offer to this show?
Well, we're making lunch soon, but we won't have... do that today, but you've been feeding soldiers on the front line,
yes,
and also evacuees in from the north and the south. And
yes,
no one realizes they're all concentrating on Gaza, but you've got drivers who drive food south and north,
correct,
to the soldiers, as well as the people who are living in hotels. Hotels have been very accommodating,
incredible.
It's a whole phenomenon now,
it's an amazing phenomenon. And I'm correct. So what I'm doing is running like a multi-prong logistics organization.
Yeah.
In Hebrew, we call it like almost like a chamal, like every soldiers basically, their needs are met by a group, an organization called a chamal, which takes care of all their needs. This is actually a military word.
Yeah.
And basically what I did, and Henry, as I told you when we were chatting before, like hundreds of thousands, or at least tens of thousands of people, are doing very similar work to myself.
Mm-hmm.
And we just recognize that these boys need more than just, you know, M36s and equipment. These boys need to know that we're there behind them every single minute. They need to know that we are there rooting for them, believing in them, and that we're ready to risk our own lives for them.
Because nutrition, like they say in the old saying, an army runs on its stomach.
Yes.
And it's so true.
Yes.
And we'll come back in the next segment because we've got a lot more to talk to you about.
We do.
And so we'll be back after the break with more of Olamit Wolf.